Destiny, and I am Heroin Project. You could express yourself about, you know, what happened to you and any other things that you really want to talk about and where you want to be in life. And that's the big one right there, where you really want to be in life. Showing your actual personality, not the following personality, the actual personality of yourself. You know, it's a lot of following, but it's like, you know, you could actually come out and be you, come out your shell and actually be the person that you was before you started following somebody else. So that's what's good about this program. I will be able to help people because of the things that I went through.
What as a black young female, what message does that music send out?
Death. Sends out a lot of death and kill each other. It just
what kind of message does it send about you as a young black girl?
Basically to be a whore. That it's okay to get beat on, it's okay to strip and show your body parts to people, men. It's okay to, you know, be raped, be molested. It's just telling you that it's okay to be wild and nasty. That's all it's teaching kids these days, is to just be nasty. A lot of violence, telling people that, you know, they should kill each other and shoot each other. Smoke, drugs, it's just very violent listening to this music nowadays. It's telling you that it's okay to smack on a girl's butt and just do stupid things to each other. That's all it's telling you to do.
Is it the music you hear around you?
Yeah.
You have kids?
Yeah.
What message is it sending to them?
It's sending to them that it's okay to be nasty. It's okay to mess with so many people, and it's okay to shoot each other. And it's just the same thing. All this music nowadays is just teaching you just to be disgusting to each other, and be disgusting to women. Period. It's not teaching the kids nowadays that, you know, you have to respect women. And, you know, a lot of people don't understand that they come from women and they treat women like dogs. And it's just nasty the way the music is nowadays. I don't know, it's so degrading nowadays how men is to females. And it's nasty these days because, you know, everybody seems like, you know, when they listen to music, they get amped up and they think that the music could save them at the end. So it's just, I don't know, it's just bad. It's bad for kids my age when that's all they're hearing going through their head is that, oh yeah, we're going to go outside with our group and we're going to go fight and we're going to go shoot something up, when in all actuality half of them is not even about that life. So it's just teaching us a quicker way to kill each other. Really, when I was growing up, I really didn't have no examples. You know, my mom, she was an alcoholic. She was there. I mean, she made sure that we had clothes on our back, food on the table. But really, it was just like, you know, my household wasn't that stable. You know, my mom always had people running in and out. You know, she was always running in and out. She was doing her own thing. You know, she left me, my older sister, and my little sister to fend for. I mean, but when it came time to eat and have clothes and have our clothes washed, she was there. She did her motherly duties. She just didn't, you know, she didn't teach us how to be women. And, you know, that was the problem. So, you know, instead of us being women, we was running around like little dogs, like we was men. You know, we was running around like we didn't care. You know, if we didn't have clothes to be washed, oh, we walk around with the same clothes on we had from the last day and didn't care. That was just because, you know, we wasn't ever taught how to be women, how to be ladies. We was taught, you know, to not give up. It was sad, but, you know, at the end, it was just like, you know, we had to start growing up on our own. and start seeing right from wrong. You know, we still did a little bit of wrong stuff, but you know, when we started to know the right stuff, you know, that's when we was going downhill. You know, we was smoking, drinking, doing what we wanted to do. And you know, I don't want to blame it on my mom, but at the same part, she plays a big part in it. You know, because you know, we watched her, you know, smoke and drink, party at the full. So we thought it was okay to do it too. All right, well, mom, you doing it, so why can't we? And you know, after a while, my mom started putting her foot down and tried to start being a mom again and, you know, trying to put us on punishment. We didn't listen to that because it's like now, oh, we was like 11. I was like 11, probably 12. My sister was like 13, 15, you know, and, oh, we didn't listen to that. We didn't listen to that. We did what we wanted to do. Because it's like, you know, all the years that we was doing what we wanted to do, now all of a sudden, you know, that we started getting breasts and ass, now you want to start being a parent. Because she didn't want us to go through the same things that she went through. But it's just like, you know, if you was there, and if you wasn't still worried about what was going on in your past, and you was there trying not to, you know, let us go through the stuff that you was going through or walking in your footsteps, then we probably wouldn't have. It was sad, but, you know, at the end, it was just like, you know, we had to start growing up on our own and start seeing right from wrong. You know, we still did a little bit of wrong stuff, but, you know, when we started to know the right stuff, you know, that's when we was going downhill. You know, we was smoking, drinking, doing what we wanted to do. And, you know, I don't want to blame it on my mom, but at the same part, she plays a big part in it, you know, because, you know, we watched her, you know, smoke and drink, party at the full, so we thought it was okay to do it too. All right, well, mom, you doing it, so why can't we? And, you know, after a while, my mom started putting her foot down and tried to start being a mom again and, you know, trying to put us on punishment. We didn't listen to that because it's like now, oh, we was like 11. I was like 11, probably 12. My sister was like 13, 15, you know. And, oh, we didn't listen to that. We didn't listen to that. We did what we wanted to do. Because it's like, you know, all the years that we was doing what we wanted to do, now all of a sudden, you know, that we started getting breasts and ass, now you want to start being a parent. Because she didn't want us to go through the same things that she went through. But it's just like, you know, if you was there, and if you wasn't still worried about what was going on in your past, and you was there trying not to, you know, let us go through the stuff that you was going through or walking in your footsteps, then we probably wouldn't have. It's hard, you know, having to sleep on the streets and go through the things that I was going through, but it was just like, you know, I wanted to be grown. So I seen that I had to hurry up and mature quick. I was pregnant. I had to, you know, get to that stage where I was just like, you know, I have to wake up. I'm about to have a baby. I don't really have nobody that's here for me other than my boyfriend. And it's like, you know, what if he leaves me? So I had to get prepared for that, you know. Even though, you know, when my mom kicked me out, he did give me a place to stay. But it was like still, from then, it's just like, you know, oh yeah, you're grown. So I had to start doing grown-up things. I had to start cleaning, washing dishes, cooking, doing everything for the household, because it's like, you can't sit here and scream that you're grown, and not do grown things, you know, and I did that a lot. There's a lot of things that I have done that is just like, you know, now when I look back on it, I'd be like, damn, I was such a kid then, and, you know, I didn't know no better, because I didn't get taught to know, you know, what's right and from wrong. Only thing I got taught was the things that I taught myself. A lot. It's a lot of people that I grew up with that live the same type of life. And it's just like, you know, I don't know what I would do if I was still stuck like them. You know, even though they went through what they went through, they got a lot more stuff that they did go through, more than what I went through. So it's just like, you know, I can't fault them for it, but at the same time, it's always time to grow up somewhere. And it's like, you know, we can't be kids forever. And I just don't understand nowadays I mean, I do understand why certain females act the way they do, but it's just like, you know, sometimes it's just time to put the big girl panties on and just to move on from what happened. I mean, not saying you gotta forget about it, but you can't just let it hold on to you forever. Sometimes you just gotta shake it off. And, you know, it does hurt, you know, knowing that girls went through the same thing that I went through.
What is that same thing?
While being molested, whether it was by, you know, family members or people that they didn't know. I know it hurts. It's still sometimes when I want to cry, you know, and just go off. But it's other times when I just be like, you know, it happened. And, you
know.
How many girls does that happen to? A lot. It's a lot of girls that it happened to. Like, 75% of girls that I know has either been raped or molested by a family member, by a friend's family member. And it's sad, but you know, you can't take that. You can't take it back. You know, you can't rewind back in time and, you know, stop it from happening.
So you never have protection, bro?
The only person that I had there, but, you know, was my brother, but, you know, it was hard because he was in and out of jail. So it's just like, you know, when he was home, I was protected, but when he was gone, I wasn't. You know, I just had my older sister, and, you know, she was there a lot to protect me, but some of the time she was going through her own thing.
You've seen some of the hate mail.
Yeah. Yeah.
You want to talk about that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I do. I see a lot of the things that people say to you, and it's sad. Because they don't see that the effort that you're trying to make, that you're trying to, you know, stop people, teens my age and younger, from doing drugs. They don't see that, you know, you see a lot of females that have been molested and been raped, and they're crying out for help, and their families don't see it, but, you know, other people see it, the outside looking in. And it's just, like, it's sad what people write to you. It's very sad. You know, it's just like, why? Why would you even write certain things that you write to somebody like that, that you see is trying to put out there that, you know, drugs is not good. That, you know,
it isn't just about drugs, it's what's leading people.
Yeah.
It's the drugs.
And it's just like, you know, calling somebody a pedophile because, you know, they're writing stuff about somebody that died. It's just like, you know, that girl went through hard things in her life. And, you know, for you actually putting it out there to say, you know, this is what she did and this is what happened to her to lead her to that. And then people just come out of nowhere and just, you know, say the nasty, hateful things that they say. It's like, you know, girls wouldn't go through this if y'all would just pay attention to them, if family members would pay attention to them. You know, you could see it. It's not hard. It's not hard to see that somebody's been molested or raped. It's not hard. You could see it. You really can. And it's like it happening to me. You know, I could see it with any female. Even if they don't say it, I could see it. Not just because it happened to me. It's because you could see how it destroys a person. You could just, like, you could see when a person that just goes into their shell and is depressed and doesn't want to do anything. You could just see, like, they're destroyed. And they turn to drugs because they're destroyed about what happened. And they don't want to think about it. But they still don't understand that even when you turn to drugs, when that high wear off, oh, you're back to thinking about what happened to you. And it doesn't matter who it is. I mean, you know, some people don't turn to drugs. You know, some people turn into alcoholics or they turn into potheads. You know, it's just like, you know, it's not all about, you know, why they do it. Well, it is all about why they do it. You know, it's just that people don't look at the background of it. You know, they be like, oh, well, she didn't report it. Some people don't. I didn't. I didn't report it. You know what I did? I started drinking. I started smoking. I started getting wild. My brain was mixed up. And then I started getting into a deep depression. And I could understand why females do that because they just feel like somebody's gonna judge them. That's why all that hateful stuff that people write, I try not to, you know, comment on it and, you know, feed off of it. But it pisses me off because it's like some of you bastards out there, it just, you don't see what we're going through. You don't see why he's publishing the things that he's saying, because y'all didn't live, y'all don't have to live the life that we went through. And, you know, some people that might, you know, comment on it might be the people that got raped or molested, and they look at you like, oh, well, you're a pervert for putting it out there. No, he's trying to save another life. It's about putting a story out there to save somebody else that's going through it. For they could read about it and be like, you know what? Let me stop doing these drugs. Let me actually, you know, go and get help and talk to somebody about it. Let me do something instead of, you know, getting high. It's bad. It's bad for us. Any drug is bad.
You see a lot of girls using drugs.
Yeah. I see nowadays, I see girls using pot, but I'm seeing more heroin than pot nowadays. You know, I ask myself why these young pretty girls is using heroin. It shocks me. It does. It shocks me. It's even males that use heroin that you could tell that something happened to them. You know, it's not just females. It's males too. But, you know.
But you think there's a contributing factor that made them turn to drugs?
Yeah.
They
yeah.
just arbitrarily pick up the drug and the drug.
Yeah, they don't just they don't just pick it up.
Is heroin the problem? Is heroin the problem?
No, heroin's not the problem. To me, heroin is not the problem. It's the background. It's the background to them doing the heroin. It's not the problem. You know, when you do coke and it ain't working for you no more, then you move up. You move up a drug. So it's like heroin is not the problem. It's the problem that happened. You know, and, you know, some families, they either don't care or they either don't want to work through the problems. You know. And it's sad. It's sad. It's very sad. But it's just like, you know, at the end, you can't help somebody that don't want to be helped. You know, some of these men out here, they don't want to be helped. They don't want to come out and be like, you know, I've been molested by this person. I've been molested by this person. And it's just like, you know, it's sad that they don't want to come out, but it's just like, it's all about being judged. That's
why,
how people look.
Why do we have more girls come here than males?
Because, females nowadays, when they feel that somebody has a good heart, then that's when they will put, you know, everything on the table and say, you know, this did happen to me. And, you know, it is a good place to come. This is like a safe house. So it's like, you know, they come here just to run away from their problems. But it's like when they get back on the street, it's the same problem again. So, yeah, they love coming here because it's like, you know, you're a person that everybody can talk to and get along with, and they know that you're not going to judge, you know. And it's sad that they don't go to their own family members, that they have to go, you know, to an outsider. But it's like, you know, everybody starts to look at you like you're a family member because you help them with their problems, you know. You talk them through it, and, you know, you get down to the problem. And you get down to, you know, why they do the things that they do. And, you know, what happened to them. You know, it's just about opening up and not feeling judged.
Charisma, and where are you from, Charisma?
From Baltimore, Maryland.
Okay. How old are you?
25 years of age.
Okay. And why are you here today?
Well, I'm here for help. Helped get myself together through the troubles and the trauma that I've been through in life. More like my life wasn't so heavenly and peacefully like everybody claims that life really is. It's kind of more harder than usual.
Mm-hmm.
But I came here because I think that I have a better chance of getting a greater outlook of who I am and what I can become.
What life is like For someone like yourself in Baltimore or in a major urban city, I'm not saying your life is the same as everybody else's, but there's a lot of commonalities of things and events that happen in your life too, other girls like yourself. Starting at the earliest age, how was your life growing up that you can remember?
Well, the things I can remember at the earliest age, me being molested by my grandfather, having a family member also leading me to get raped, smoking, drinking as a child from the age of 6 till God's know when. I finally found a place where I could feel safe and at ease, that I wouldn't even have to think about smoking or drinking. That's what I found in this program. So that's mostly and mainly why I'm here, and also making a better person of myself for me and my child and people around me.
What happened? Let's start with your grandfather. How old were you and when did this happen?
I was 5 or 6 years old when I remember. He used to dress me up like a grown woman. He used to have these silicone breasts and makeup and stuff, and he said that it wasn't nothing wrong with it, it's just a game and it's between us and it's okay, it's normal. Then it led all the way up until I was at least 9 or 10 when I really realized that it wasn't right. And he used to wing me into it by, he'd say, "Oh, I will buy you this and get you that." And that's me being a child. I'm like, okay, but not knowing that it's actually wrong. That is, he actually touching on me in places where I really felt uncomfortable. But at that time, I wasn't really even sure was it right or if it was wrong, because he was the adult, and okay, for an adult tell you something that is okay, you think that it's okay, mainly.
How when you found out it's wrong?
I found out it was wrong once I actually heard another person say that they went through the same thing by being molested by somebody in their family, and I went to my parents and my grandparents and them, and basically they shut me out and said that it never happened, I was lying, I'm just making up stories. But I don't understand why would they say that, because they also told me in their life it happened to them. So
by the same man?
By the same man.
So you went to your mother, you went to your dad, you met, you told them the details of everything, and they denied it.
Well, not my dad. My dad wasn't ever really there for me at those point of time. So he denied me even after the DNA test came out that I'm his, and another guy actually raised me and did a great job, and he's the one that put it to my mom and my family attention that, okay, as me being as young as I was, why would I make something up like that? It's impossible for a child to constantly keep the same story that went on. So it's kind of crazy how family actually shut you out and blindside the real actions that goes on in your life so they can, basically, so they won't be embarrassed. Things like that. They want to keep it indoors, mostly.
You had indicated that you've been drinking since the age of 6. How'd that happen?
Well, my grandma started giving me cans of beer probably younger than 6. The people that only could help me just ignored me.
Meaning your mother and...
My mom, my grandma, my aunts, and people that really should have been there for me, the females in my family that should have been there, because they know it's hard for females out here and things is easier to happen to us. And it happened to them, so I felt as though that, okay, since it happened to me, why didn't they shelter me or keep me out of harm's way or try to at least get me out, to try to get me to sleep. But then they graduated to Jack Daniels and other things. But then over time, it just got worse. So once I got older, I felt as though, okay, my grandma gave it to me, so why not drink? I felt as though wasn't nothing wrong with it. Okay, I just started drinking. Then my drinking ended up getting worse, worse, and worse, and worse, to the point that I was able to consume a gallon and a half by myself in one night.
At what age?
From the age of 12 all the way to 24.
Wow. Where was anybody at during this time? Was there anybody you could go to?
Well, not really, because my mom and them always busy worked and went to school, and I was mostly always around my older siblings, like my sister, my older cousins, and things like that. But they was older than me, so they also did things that wasn't prohibited for me, but I also seen them do things, so that made me also want to experience what they was doing, because they said that it was so much fun. It seemed like it was fun back then, but as in time growing up, I don't see it so much fun now.
What did your cousin do to you?
Well, my cousin set me up, drugged me to get raped so she can keep her boyfriend. Okay. At the age of 12.
How did that help her keep her boyfriend?
I don't know, by giving me to him, basically so-called saved their relationship, and it traumatized me because I shut down for a nice amount of years, and I forgive her, but I also don't, because why would family put you in harm's way that way at the age of 12? Innocent, not knowing what's going on. I sit my Smirnoff ice cooler down and went to the bathroom. For some reason, she didn't want to walk me. And okay, I was like, okay, I'll just go myself. And when I came back, my mom always told me, once you open your drink and sit it down, don't pick it back up. But as she being my cousin, I trust her. And I finished off my drink and I started feeling dizzy. And that's the last thing I remember. But when I woke up, my private area was hurting. I couldn't hold my bladder. I was bleeding from my vaginal area. My mom, I was scared to tell my mom because I thought that they was going to say it was my fault. But when I did let my mom know, she took me to the hospital, and that's when I found out that he gave me chlamydia, my first time.
Were there any charges pressed against him? Or your grandfather or anybody?
No, everybody just basically shut it out like it never happened. So, no. I got pregnant at 13. I didn't want to keep her because I know I was too young and I still wanted to go to school, but my mom said that it's against God and you'll go to hell for that. So basically I was forced to have her, and she also said that she would be there to help me, which I didn't really get much help from her. She cussed me out if I even needed baby Pampers. I used to literally have to sell myself for my daughter to get clothing.
At age 14?
14. All the way until 16, I finally stepped up to what they call a bigger level in life. I started hustling and doing other things that's not really right. But I had to survive and take care of mine. I wasn't even able to finish school because even the schools were scared for me to be in regular school because how much anger I had. I always wanted to fight, just fight, fight, fight. And since I was pregnant, they wanted to send me to a pregnant school, and which I did not want to go there, because I had a very bad attitude problem and anger. So I didn't feel as though that me being around a whole bunch of emotional pregnant females, that's going to just send me more off a deep end.
Has this happened to many other girls that you know?
It happened.
Maybe not the same, but similar things.
Yeah, similar things happen.
Like the rape and the molestation?
Yes. I also had a couple homegirls that mom used to sell them to the drug dealers just to get her fix and stuff like that. I used to take food out my house to feed them. I also used to steal money from my mom so they can have clean clothes, clean drawers, and stuff like that. And they didn't have no electricity, no hot water, nothing. So basically their mom prostituted them so she can get high.
Was this a lot of your friends?
I had a limit of female friends because I was going through my own drama-full and harsh life. I really didn't want to really bring in any other females because me, I'm very sensitive and emotional about rape, molestation, and things like that, and the way, and when other females tell me about what happened to them in their life, it actually hurts me, and it seems like it's more weight on my shoulders. So I tried to keep my circle very small, and I like to keep myself distant from people because I really didn't like to really talk about my life or tell people like what happened to me and things like that, so nobody won't judge me.
Did you talk to many people about it that you could confide in?
I had one therapist that I really connected with, and when I told her my story, I was her last patient. She quit. She said she couldn't take it. So.
How old were you then?
I was at 17 years old.
It's okay. It's really okay. Take your time.
just got harder in time as I got older. I had to work at the club. No, that was a life. Having different guys grab on you, and basically you have to be what they want you to be to survive down there and things like that. And the things that I seen, the things that I witnessed, it just like outrageous. Like, but I had no other choice. I started at the age of 17. I stole my friend ID because she was 18 at the time. And I looked at like her, so I started down the block at 17 all the way until I was 24. And it didn't, in the beginning it was easy because I stayed high and drunk, so basically. But after all that, the drugs and the drink wear off, I feel disgusted. I felt like nothing. Because my family really didn't care to help. I would get cussed out if I even asked for $5 to get something to eat. So I had no other choice but to make the decisions that I made.
You're in this hard area. Is it safe to assume that all the other girls you were around went through the same things?
They probably went through the same thing or worse. Because I heard stories about girls being pushed out of cars, going 60 miles per hour on the highway. One of my homegirls got shot in the head and they put her body behind an elementary school. I had a best friend, and he was my best friend. And he went to go take me home, and out of nowhere, someone rolled up beside him and shot him in his head, and that tremendously sent me to a dark hole, because his head was on my shoulders and blood everywhere. I couldn't move, I couldn't speak, I couldn't see. I couldn't do anything. It's kind of hard to actually live in Maryland because you can't even speak to someone without them wanting to fight you or thinking something negative, anything like that. It's more bars and more clubs than schools or libraries or playgrounds. The hustlers down there, they basically destroy the kids' playgrounds. So where do the kids go? There's no recreation centers no more. It's nothing.
Until you come and sit a while with me. you.